Well, we enjoyed some record-setting cool weather for the month of July here in Kansas City, and so far rainfall has been above normal this summer, too.
It's the perfect recipe for bugs. KMBC 9 meteorologist Erin Little is live tonight in Lee Summit. Hope you have your bug spray handy, Erin.
Yes, I am prepared, guys. I'm ready to go this evening for my visit to the park. How about you, photographer Alan Ball? Do you have your bug spray? All right, he's ready to go too. And hopefully the folks behind me that you see, they're enjoying the park tonight. And this nice break from the summer heat has given folks a great excuse to get outside and enjoy this nice weather. The only problem is we're not the only ones. Both mosquitoes and ticks are loving this cooler and wetter summer too.
Are you itching, scratching, and swatting away the bugs this summer? You aren't the only one.
Our mosquito populations have been pretty high because we've had a kind of a mild summer with a lot of rains.
And without our normal summertime heat, more standing water means more of something else.
It gives them a lot of breeding ground where they can continue to lay eggs throughout the summer and reproduce multiple times. And that's led to a lot of the annoying mosquitoes that we see.
And it's not just this summer. The weather many months ago is a factor, too.
Yeah, and that's the incredible part of it is we tend to think kind of in the here and now, but a lot of the insect populations are due to the weather that we've seen up to a year ago.
More ticks this summer are a good example of that.
We see a lot of those tick populations because of the weather we had last summer, which unfortunately, since we're having a similar weather this summer, we may expect to see high tick populations next year as well.
And it's not just people, but some gardens and trees have been hit hard. Harder this summer with bugs too. Are the tips of your tree starting to brown? This bug could be to blame.
Hermes scale, which is affecting a lot of the pin oaks, which is a pretty common tree in people's yard around Blue Springs, Independence, and been hearing a lot in Clay County as well.